Hello, hello, hello. This is Ash, and welcome to my latest video to come on my channel, as we are now in March 2015. Tonight, I'm going to be reviewing the Atlas Editions Mercedes-Benz L1519, which I believe is a 1960s Mercedes-Benz German fire engine. I just bought this as an oddball to my relatively small collection of fire engines from all over the world and by various makes, and I will be covering those later in the year or as time permits. This one I did buy pre-owned, as I didn't collect the Atlas Edition range, as I like to collect the particular fire engines that I like rather than just put up with those that I do not. But anyways, I believe this is in the 176 scale. Does come with a nice Perspex case, and I did buy this pre-owned. The only defect is that one of the wing mirrors is missing, but that doesn't matter too much, as I did pick this up for around, I think it was £16, with free postage on top, off eBay, as these tend to retail for around 20 to 24 for a mint condition model anyways. Right, just going to take it off camera for a brief moment whilst removing all the packaging. There isn't any information on the outer sleeve, but I just thought I'd include it during the introduction of the video just to show you what the model looks like when new. If you collect this series yourself, you do get a nice plastic plinth with imitation tarmac on the top, as it's not one of those smooth plinths that you get with some of the cheaper models, such as certain makes that I've previously covered in the past. Right, let's start with the front, shall we? I'm just going to zoom in, as I have just noticed upon checking my LCD screen on my video camera, we are quite afar from the actual truck, as this truck is a lot smaller than the double-decker bus that I've just previously covered. The headlights are glazed. There is only one wing mirror, which is on the driver's side. There is etched wipers. The detail is reasonable, although I did have to refit one of the emergency lights back onto the ladder, as it did come off during transit. So these models don't really cope too well unless they are extremely well packed during the post, but nonetheless, it's not something that I couldn't fix anyways. So just going clockwise, just want to briefly show you all what the model entails. Unfortunately, the ladder does not extend, so I cannot extend the ladder, as it will just snap off the top of the truck, as it's just for static purposes. So can't really demonstrate anything special about this truck, although it does have freewheeling wheels, and it does fit in with the 00 gauge model railways, as it is made to 176 scale, as opposed to the common European 1 to 87th HO scale. So this fire engine is a bit of an oddball. But it is something to consider if you wanted to kit bash a fire engine out of this that is something more British. But for me, it does the job, and I shall have this on my model railway when I get round to building one in the future. But likewise, we're just coming to the end of our rotation, using my brand new turntable. Just going to put the fire truck in a nice close-up position, and I shall round this review off with an 8 out of 10, as it is a nice truck. Price-wise, depending on the condition of this model, expect to pay anything from 16 to around 26 UK, depending on the condition and the availability of this model. But other than that, that concludes my review. Thank you for watching. Please feel free to post any comments in the comment section below. Until next time, take care everybody, and bye for now.